I always wanted to experience things like microscopes and stuff like that. We had none of that. We simply had a classroom, paper, and none of that. And that's when I started to feel like, you know, we're missing something here. There was a white high school right down the street from us. They had everything. Biology labs, they did everything. And then I'm starting to wonder, why do they have that and we have that?
Joseph Paudrell grew up in Crosbyton, Texas. This pamphlet from the time calls it a progressive and forward-looking town. This image says there's a place for you. But to Paudrell, who attended a segregated elementary school, it didn't always feel that way.
Then I'm starting to realize why the deprivations. Why are we deprived of certain things? And the word racism wasn't mentioned. That was, you know, just that's the way white people are. This is the way we are. And make the best of it.
So it wasn't viewed as racism.
No.
It was just two different life experiences.
Yeah. This is suitable for you. This is suitable for us.
By the late 1950s and the beginning of the civil rights movement, he and his family moved to Albuquerque, hoping for better opportunity. When it was time for college, he decided to go to the University of New Mexico, running track on scholarship.
What did you think about the civil rights movement when it was going on?
I was always impressed with the fact that people weren't taking it. I remember on campus, and I'm talking to the University of New Mexico at the time, we didn't have an African-American studies program. So students started to engage. I remember we were doing sit-ins. That was the latter part of my college career. I was just about out of college at the time. But it felt good. But the reaction to it, the people who were active in it, troublemakers. So now you have a choice. Do you want to be viewed this way or do you just want to chill?
So what was it like for you, having seen the civil rights movement play out during your own lifetime, to then also see another movement? When we saw the protests that took place last summer, George Floyd protest, in Albuquerque and nationwide, what did you think about that and how did that compare to the marches of the 1960s?
Those movements in the 60s were, I won't say they were much more violent. They appeared to be violent because the world didn't want that. You know, America didn't want that kind of visible reaction to what's been wrong. We're going to work it out. Don't worry about it.
Did you think the George Floyd protests were similar or were they different?
I think similar in the issue was the same. You know, that kind of brutality. I haven't seen that. George Floyd's, he was like another one.
As the fight for justice and equality continues.
Together we are more.
I would say to your generation, when life is all said and done, what you think about yourself is going to be the bottom line. You be who you want to be. You be who you want to be.
In Albuquerque, I'm Kayla Norwood.